In this video, I want to briefly talk about what I learned over the last 8 years working as a remote UI UX and web designer when it comes to sales specifically. So when I first started out, I remember that sales was this very nasty concept almost. It was very, like, just thinking about it was overwhelming, like the idea of the sales call of, you know, going and meeting a client and having to use maybe like tactics or, you know, have a certain mindset in order to close the sale. And all of those things were really difficult to grasp. And, you know, I was always overthinking when I was having a call. And that is something that, looking back, it should have never happened, because at the end of the day, what I discovered over, you know, hundreds of sales calls is just that a sales call isn't really a sales call, meaning that it's just a call where you're trying to figure out if you can deliver value to an individual, and in exchange that individual is going to give value to you. But it's always an exchange, so it's not like you have to go there and try to prove yourself in a very strong way, and you know, having to use any like techniques and things which are really like, you know, out of this world. Like, you don't have to read minds or you know, doing all those kind of things. Sales, at the end of the day, in my personal opinion, is just prospecting for the vast majority of it. By prospecting, I'm referring to, you know, analyzing the type of goals and needs that the person has, and then figuring out if your expertise or your team can solve that person's problems. And that's essentially what it is. You always also want to like dive deeper and dig deeper in the problems, and there's all sorts of techniques which you know, I discuss in the course. But for the most part, you have to see it. You always have to see yourself as a doctor who is learning from a person what his issues are, what his background was like, and all sorts of different useful informations, in order to, at the end of the session, either create a prescribe a treatment to that person, or refer that person to someone else, to another doctor who maybe is more specialized in those things. And that's one of the reasons why I don't endorse the idea of, you know, just thinking about the closing rate. You hear all of these, you know, big gurus and big CEOs that are saying like, oh yeah, you always want to maintain a high closing rate. It makes sense if you're a leader of a company and you're driving a sales team. Like, that's a no-brainer. You want to have a high closing rate. Or if you just have, you know, to meet ends meet, and you have like a company with a lot of monthly expenses. But if you're a designer and a consultant or, you know, a freelancer, you don't really want to work with everyone, especially since most of you guys are not going to have a team that is just going to like pass the client to the team. Maybe in that case, it makes a little bit more sense. But I personally, the way I structured my business is that I'm a high paid consultant. I don't outsource the work simply because I don't want to grow my business in that direction. I'm outsourcing other things which are creating passive income sources, and that's going to give me like more freedom. And regardless, the main concept is that if you're doing the work, you don't want to work with any client who's willing to pay. And I did that mistake several times in the past. I just saw the dollars amount and I said, yes, absolutely, let's do it, let's get started. But I didn't do the prospecting well for that client. And what ends up happening is that you have issues. Maybe that problem, that client is a pain to deal with. Maybe that client is not going to be responsive because it's not an urgent project for them. Or, you know, all sorts of different things that you kind of need to know by now what to really look out for and what to avoid, really. Because if you work with the wrong client, and especially if you have a business like mine where I'm working with a handful of clients during the month, I can count them on the fingers of one hand. And when that count goes to five, that's a lot of work usually. So I want to keep my clientele very small, and I only want to work with people who I can deliver value to, who are ideally, I wouldn't say necessarily all of them are A players, but almost. And but at least they have a successful business. They are not, with they have a good amount of cash flow. They don't make all sorts of like stupid business decisions and those kind of things. So I want to work with people who are good people, who treat me well, who are not expecting designs to be done yesterday. And you know, there's all of these dynamics which you kind of create yourself, because I actually thought that having this bad design clients was the industry's fault, but the reality is that in every single industry there's good clients, there's bad clients, and the design industry is no different. You always have good clients, you're always going to have bad clients, and you take the decision and the responsibility of onboarding a client and having them work with you. So if you have a bad client, it's because you didn't do the prospecting right in the first place. And that's something which took me a lot of time to understand, that it was my responsibility, that of the type of business that I had. I simply had to say no to certain amount, to certain people, to certain businesses. And you know, that's something which is totally fine. And it's hard to do at the beginning, because you're probably going to be left with less opportunities. And especially if you don't have a lot of money in a period of time, I know this can be especially hard, but once you get a little nest egg, you're going to have more flexibility, and you can totally build that up and just cut expenses which don't really need in your life. So really keep that in mind, always have a nest egg so that you have the freedom to say no to certain clients. And that's going to make all the difference in the mindset and the way you live your day and life, really. Like, we're talking about your life. You're going to work. Likelihood that you're going to work most part of the week is really high if you're like us normal designers. So you want to work with people who appreciate your work, who you can deliver value to, and that with whom you can create a good, healthy work environment. And yeah, this is like super, super important, because the wrong clients are just going to like drag you down, and you're going to be in the pit before you know it. And this is true also in personal relationship and everything in life. So I believe it's a universal principle. You want to be selective with the people who you accept in your inner circle, and especially in business, because business is already hard as it is. You're already going to have challenges each and every day at work. So why making it harder by working with people who you don't enjoy working with, who that you cannot bring value? Because if you cannot bring value to a person, that's going to chase you down the line. Maybe you can close the sale. And I've been there, done that. I closed like a high ticket sale, but I wasn't 100% sure about the value. And I discovered later that, I couldn't give as much as I thought I could. And that's an error which, you know, I specifically think about a project years ago. And that's something which, you know, I don't want to do ever again, that mistake. Because you always want to be in a position where you're working with people with whom that you can create and give value to, and that they're willing to give back. So hope this helps. A lot of it is practice. You can hear all of the videos, you can go through all of the training and memorize everything, but a lot of it, to be honest, is practice. It's just trying things out, hopping on sales goal after sales goal, just going at it, never giving up, and just, you know, making those small 0.001% improvements each and every day. And then you look back months from now, or even years from now, and you say, wow, how much did I improve in such a short period of time? And yeah, journey is awesome. Can be brutal at times, but it's so worth it, guys. So just keep going at it, and you're going to make it.